So here we're going to take a plan in AutoCAD, put it into Photoshop, and then render it to create a realistic plan render. So if we start with our plan, this is based on this apartment, a two-bedroom flat in central London. If you aren't sure how to draw a plan in CAD, then refer to this video here, which I'll link. So step one, open the plan in CAD. So you'll see we've already added a floor hatch in AutoCAD for the floorboards and also our furniture, which you'll see in the previous video. Step two, set up a new layout sheet in AutoCAD. We do this by, in our tab at the bottom, left click the plus arrow tab, and AutoCAD will make a new layout sheet. Then we want to set up this layout to make it look like what we want it to look like with our plan. So right click and do page setup manager. So now this will appear in a new window, and with this current page setup highlighted, select modify to bring up the page setup window. And then from this, we need to change some of the settings in the page setup window so that it will export a PDF as we want. So for printer and plotter, do AutoCAD PDF. Paper size, I'm going to do ISO full bleed A3, but if you're using US paper sizes, you can do an 11 by 17 or one of your standard larger paper sizes. Plot style table is our own interiors defined CTB file, or you can use your own if you don't have this. And then what to plot, layout, plot scale 1:1, and drawing orientation, do landscape. And then okay to confirm. The layout is now regenerated and should be an A3 landscape sheet. Okay, so now we're in the layout. We need to set up a viewport for the plan. So create a new layer called viewport. Toggle the layer plot to not plot. This just means the viewport will not show up as a rectangle on the final sheet. And then double left click into the viewport. In the viewport settings tab, on the bottom right, the current scale is displayed. So we want to left click the scale and select 1:50. So now this is a 1:50 plan on our layout. Now use the pan tool to position the plan so that it's relatively centered on our A3 layout. And then you want to lock the viewport so it can't move. Then left double click outside the viewport to exit the model space and return to paper space. Step three, export the plan as a PDF. So you can either do this file export PDF and then save the PDF, or you can use the command export PDF and then enter. And save your PDF somewhere convenient so you can bring it into Photoshop in our next step. Step four, open Photoshop and create a new Photoshop file. Now you want to make this the same paper size as that layout that you made. So I'm going to make this an A3 landscape, but again, if you did a different paper size, then go with that one for your Photoshop document. Step five, import the PDF plan. Okay, now we can place our PDF that we exported from AutoCAD. Using file place, our place window appears. Now just select the PDF that you exported. And now we have the place PDF. So in crop to, choose crop box and then select okay. And now press enter and you now have your plan in Photoshop at the correct scale. Step six, add a wall hatch to our plan. So at this point, now we've got the plan and you can close AutoCAD, but now let's start working with it in Photoshop. So let's create a new layer in Photoshop called Walls Hatch. Now select the magic wand tool and click inside each of the sections of solid walls until all of the walls are included in the selection. Now use the fill tool to fill the selection in a suitable color. So I'll choose black here, but you can always change this in the next step. So now in the layers toolbar, right click on the layer and select blending options. Choose color overlay and you can choose a mid gray or a dark gray color here and your wall hatch will change color. Step 7 is add your floor textures. So now we're going to start using our finishes that hopefully you've got for your project. So the first thing that I would do is, in any project, you're probably going to have material boards with all of the materials and finishes that you know. So I always keep these at hand and either find images of them from the supplier websites and save them in one folder, or you can take photos of the samples that you've got and then save them into a folder so you have them all ready to go. So I've got this folder here with all of my finishes that I'm going to use for this plan. So we'll start by placing the floorboards. So you do File, Place, select the texture image for the floor finish, and then the Transform tool appears and allows for scaling. Now you want to uniformly scale the image to a realistic size in the plan. Okay, now let's use the layer mask tool. So a mask is just going to hide parts of the layer that you don't want to see, but it allows you to bring them back in at a later point, which is why it's non-destructive, so it's better than using delete. Click on the layer mask to create one of the masks for the wood floor layer. Now use the marquee tool and holding down shift, add your selections for all of the rooms with the wood floor finish. And now with the layer mask active in the layers tab, click fill and fill that area with black. So for black, it's hiding and it's masking all of the areas in black. Step 7 is to continue adding the floor textures. So now we're going to do one of the bathroom floor finishes. So the key is repeat the process again. So import your finish texture, select the area and then mask it, and then do any effects such as lowering the opacity or changing the brightness as required. Now next one is the guest bathroom floor finish. Again, import the texture, place, scale, and change any color or brightness as required. And mask the area as required again. Next is the marble countertops in the kitchen. Again, import texture, mask, and then place. Then here, I'm just going to organize our layers by putting all of the floor finish layers into a folder called Floor Finishes. Next, we can also do this process for loose rugs or carpeting. So here I'm going to do the living room carpet. So as before, place the texture, select the area to mask, and then confirm. Again, place the texture, scale, and then create a mask for the area needed. And then finally, we have the same stone, the marble for the fireplace. And so now you should have all of the finishes ready. Step 8, add furniture shadows. So with furniture, and especially with things like sofas, if you see photos of them, they often have a shadow below them where, you know, either where the sofa is blocking natural light or it's blocking the, you know, the downlights or the spotlights above. So that's what we're going to add to these pieces of furniture. Select the areas of furniture in the living room, such as the sofa, the console table, the bookcases, the armchair, the side table, and now fill the selection with white color. Then right click on the layer and select layer style. Choose drop shadow from the styles window. And I'm going to use the following settings for adding these shadows. So I use a multiply bit blend mode, drop the opacity down a bit, increase the distance and add this spread, which gives it the soft diffused shadow effect, and also bump up the size until you think it looks something realistic, but not too bold. We want to keep it quite subtle, which makes it more realistic. And I add just a small bit of noise, which adds a little bit of grain and variety to it, but you don't have to do this. Step 9 is add daylight to all of the window openings. So this is the natural light, as we said before. I'm just going to use the marquee tool to select areas around the windows. And now using the brush tool, right click and make the brush a larger size, make it white color, and now drop the opacity a bit. And then just click once in the middle of each window pane. And now you'll see that there's this white light, but it looks quite bold. So we're going to use the layer blending mode and just change this until we get an effect which looks quite realistic for daylight or sunlight coming in our windows. So this now looks good. Step 10 is add more shadows for all the other rooms with furniture and windows, as we have done in our previous steps. So I'll just add those and we'll now see how it looks once these are all added. Step 11 is add a layer mask to any doors, including closets, wardrobes, cabinets, things like that. And that's because obviously if this is a plan cutting through, the doors and cabinets, they're going to obscure the floor finish below. So we'll use a mask to hide any floors like that. And finally, just to make the plan complete, I'm going to add some room labels using the Photoshop text tool. And then after this, our plan looks quite ready for presentation. Right, and here is our final image. I hope that was useful. If you have any feedback, do leave a comment. If you found this useful, please do like, share, and subscribe. It really helps. And thanks very much, and I will see you next time.